What's going on, guys? Happy Thursday. I'm Mackenzie Mitchell. This is Alicia Taylor, and welcome to What's Next. Tuesday was fun on Sci-Fi.
Tuesday was incredible. Yes.
Okay, but I have to say, and I'm not just saying this because they're our guests today.
What do you have to say?
Match of the night. Creed Brothers from Diamondmine.
Mackenzie, you're already GYV. Kissing up.
I'm not. I'm just saying it was the match of the night.
Here are your winners, the Creed Brothers.
The first ticket to the finals of the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic, punched by the Creed Brothers of Diamond Mine.
Okay, without further ado, please
representing Diamond Mine, please welcome Julius and Brutus, the Creed Brothers.
Woo!
Hey guys.
Welcome to What's Next.
What's up?
I just wanted to break the ice here and ask if I could maybe, you know, how can I go about getting a tracksuit?
You gotta earn it, and that's the only way.
Absolutely.
Do you think that's possible?
What does she have to do to get a tracksuit?
Blue ain't really your color anyway.
Great. Okay. Well, that wasn't very nice.
The shade of blue.
You guys are now in the finals of the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. What does that mean for you guys?
You want to play Barbara Walters? You better do your homework, Mackenzie. What does it mean for us? You need to be asking MSK, what does it mean for them? They're going to be the ones sharing the ring with us. We started sleeping on the mats at 6 weeks old. We started competing at 3 years old. Before you could read or write, we were throwing bodies. This is what we're born and bred and brought up to do. It's Creed Brothers for Dusty Cup, it's Bad Boys for Life, and it's Diamond Mine Forever. That's what we do. Which brings me to the point. Where's Malcolm? Where's Roddy? Where's Ivy? We don't have enough room on the set for them?
Well, we certainly do. Why don't you take
this one? That's our family. Malcolm, that's our biological older brother. That's big bro. Roddy's not here. Ivy. I think we're done here. Yeah.
This is it?
It's like that.
We have more questions for you guys.
Yeah.
Though,
Well, I just basically got insulted the entire time. He also told me blue is not my color. Do you think blue is my color?
That's what
I'm stuck on.
You did get insulted the entire time.
What happened with that?
What happened?
Why does Diamond Mine hate me?
What? But you know what? I do disagree with them. You do look good in blue.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Well, you know what? It's okay that they left because we do have other guests here today.
Yeah, we sure do.
You know what? Maybe they're going to be nicer
than
the Creed Brothers. Should we do it?
Yeah, let's bring them on.
Let's bring them on. Please welcome Indi Hartwell and Persia Pirotta.
Hey!
Hello.
Hi! Oh my gosh, look at that!
You know what? What a change. I mean, Creed Brothers came.
They were so mean to me.
You guys are already starting with compliments.
Oh,
they're totally wrong.
You can wear every single color.
I've seen you wear every color, and you can.
You know what? From now on out, we're only going to book on our show Indi Hartwell and Persia Pirotta.
I am actually ex-host.
I was gonna say, you've been on What's Next quite a few times and hosted when I wasn't here. Thank you.
Yeah. You do have a good Mackenzie impression.
I'm Mackenzie Mitchell for WWE Now, and here's what you need to know for today's What's Next.
Oh, yes! Wow.
Amazing.
And I love the American accent that you really pull out.
It's like the accent of Dexter, Missouri, your hometown.
I am from Dexter, Missouri.
She's very good.
You know,
Dexter, Missouri. She's from Dexter. Now I know why you like Mackenzie.
Yeah.
Right. Let's talk about you guys' friendship from the very beginning. I mean, you both have obviously aspired to be WWE superstars since you were
forever.
Indi, you have photos of yourself at a WWE live event in Australia. What does it mean to be like in a tag team with your best friend in WWE?
It's special because, as you said, like, it was always our goal to get to WWE, and now we're both here at the same time. We get to do it side by side, so it's really cool.
Mm. Okay, well, I have to ask. Duke Hudson has recently came into the picture, and it seems like, Persia, you have a little crush on Duke?
I've tweeted at him.
Oh, okay.
You tweeted to Duke Hudson?
Yeah. I sent him a DM as well.
Did he respond?
I think he was busy, but
it may have ended up in the message requests.
Yeah.
You know that happened.
It says seen, so I think he's seen it.
Okay. Oh, he just probably forgot.
Sometimes you see a message and you forget.
You need to go to the
toilet. I do that all the time.
I'm sure Dexter does that all the time.
Is it hot in here?
There was a photo of you and Duke Hudson on the floor or something.
Yeah.
Do we have the photos?
Persia, did you see, because this is, did you see it?
That's an old blast from the past.
Everyone saw it.
You know where they say blast from the past.
This is the picture that we're talking about. That. What are you eating here? It looks good, actually.
Yeah, is that like ice cream?
Is that gelato? Is that Ferrero Rocher? That's my favorite flavor. How did you know that?
That's a little awkward.
Okay.
Let's talk about your huge title opportunity next week at Vengeance Day.
Yes.
What would a title win mean for you guys?
Well, it would mean a two-time NXT Women's Tag Team Champion. And it would be my first championship in WWE. Right. So it would mean a lot. It would be very, very cool to have a championship in WWE tagging with my best
come
friend.
A long way from buying the replica championships on WWEshop.com.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it would mean literally everything.
Well, ladies, again, best of luck next week at Vengeance Day. Go get those titles.
Thank you so much.
And when you do, come back and visit us.
That's right. You're always welcome.
Well, whenever you're off, when you don't want to come into work, you know, I can always fill
in. Yeah, she's been taking up basket weaving, pumpkin pie making.
Been busy.
Oh, wow.
She's been skydiving.
Oh, my God.
Been
I love
trampoline.
Pumpkin pie.
You love pumpkin pie.
Really
I love
trampoline.
I'm going to make you a pumpkin pie.
She's becoming a makeup artist.
Have you had a pumpkin
pie? She loves to knit.
Yeah, I do. I have a lot of skills.
She's been learning guitar, violin,
drums,
bass.
I mean, I do play drums.
Violin.
You said violin twice.
Ukulele. I'm sorry.
What about the cello?
I know. Cello.
The double bass.
The tuba.
The tuba.
The flute. The recorder.
Oh, I want to show you my tuba. Can I come see the tuba? All right, let's go.
It's just, we're all here.
Here we are.
We're all here.
Okay. So, do you remember how to do this?
Yeah, I think so.
So you want to help me tell everybody what's happening
you
next
week? You want to take it away or
I'll start.
Okay.
No, actually you start. You go ahead and you start it off.
Next week at Vengeance Day, we have the finals of the Dusty Classic Tournament, the Creed Brothers against MSK.
And we also are going to see Pete Dunne versus Tony D'Angelo in a weaponized steel cage match. Brutals.
We can't forget my match. Mrs. Loomis and Big Purge, Indian Imperator against Toxic Attraction. And I'm going to become a two-time NXT Women's Tag Team Champion, and Purge is going to win her first championship in NXT.
We hope so. And of course, we're going to see the NXT Championship being defended as Bron Breakker. Defends his championship against Santos Escobar.
Big challenge for Bron Breakker.
Yeah, absolutely. Make sure you watch Vengeance Day next week on Sci-Fi. And of course, catch NXT action every single Tuesday on the USA Network. Indi Hartwell.
What's next?
Say it louder.
What's next? And do you want to do the no look?
Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Did you just blow Dexter a kiss?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Cool. Well, we're all here.
We're all here.